We're here in Suidobashi, Tokyo, Japan.
And we are going to take you for some OG style ramen, Chukasoba at Katsumoto. Come, let's go. You're going to love this.
松村康と言います。ここ勝本の料理長をしております。ラーメンを始めたきっかけは、昔、フレンチを作っていましたが、ラーメンはこの丼一つで全ての美味しさが凝縮されております。オードブルからメインディッシュ、スープ、全てがこの一皿に入っております。
Okay, let's talk Chukasoba. I am positive that a lot of you guys have never even heard of this phrase before.
You always think of konkotsu ramen, right. You think of miso ramen, yeah. You think of shoyu ramen,
which is like soy sauce,
and you think of shio ramen,
which is salt ramen. But a lot of people don't really think about Chukasoba,
exactly.
Which is such a shame because it is, as we mentioned before, the OG, the vintage, some of the most original ramen that exists in Japan.
Now don't get confused with the word soba. When you're thinking soba, you're probably thinking of that like Nihachi soba from the video that we did
Yeah, like the buckwheat noodles.
So Chukasoba just means a Chinese noodle. It's an old way of saying it. Now they pretty much just call it ramen, but still, like, if you want that kind of like vintagey feel, people call it Chukasoba.
Now, although this is kind of like Chinese style ramen, it shouldn't be mistaken as being Chinese ramen.
And I know you might be thinking, oh, if I'm in Japan, I only want to eat Japanese food, but kind of think about it. Remember when we did a video about jajangmyeon in Korea? Jajangmyeon is a staple of Korean food now, even though it's inspired by Chinese food. If you avoid jajangmyeon, you're missing out on a huge part of Korean food culture. If you skip out on Chukasoba, you're not a ramen hardcore fan. Mm-mm. You're not a ramen otaku. Mm-mm. You're a poser. You need to eat Chukasoba in order to get the real ramen experience.
Hi, I'm Kenichi Matsumura, and I'm a chef here at Katsumoto. The soy sauce ramen is considered like the origin of ramen in Japan. So it's very light, yet it's very flavorful. We put lots of ingredients, so fish, chicken, pork, also kelps. Each one has like a slight flavor, so you can enjoy the mixture of many flavors.
Now there are a lot of options to choose from at this amazing restaurant.
I'm getting the Tokusei ramen, which is pretty much the deluxe version and has extra toppings of everything because I'm big and I'm hungry and I've been smelling this ramen as they've been cooking it and I really want to eat as much of it as I can. Things I want people to know about ramen.
Go for it.
It's delicious.
Yes.
I want to eat it every day.
Yes.
And I don't want to get fat from eating it every day.
That's not going to happen. Oh my god, I just got an extra whiff of like some kind of porky chicken magic happening. Salivation.
My chest is tingling.
Yes. Our ramen senses are, what's that?
What's
there's,
that?
There's ramen nearby.
Oh.
It's coming.
Okay.
Hi. Arigatou gozaimasu.
Look at that boy. It's always really hard to shoot a ramen video because the noodles expand if you wait for too long, so you just gotta go right in.
The top layer of the broth has like a thin sheen of oil on top of it, but it's not so thick like a tonkotsu ramen. Oh, the colors are dense.
Here we go.
Soupを仕上げるためには10時間かかっております。
I'd like you to drink the soup first because the soup is the part of the ramen that most thought and time goes into.
Oh boy.
Oh my god. That is fantastic. When you have a tonkotsu ramen, sometimes it's so thick and oily that you can't really finish it.
Mm-hmm.
But this one has that lightness of like a shoyu, like of a soy sauce ramen.
Because I don't usually like shoyu ramens because I just find they're a bit too bland. I think the oiliness of this really gives me that tonkotsu flavor that I really like.
Yeah, well, it's got, you know, pork in it as well as chicken, as well as fish. So it's like everything coming together.
Eat the ramen by slurping it. While eating ramen, it is like the best way to get the proper balance between soup and the noodle, and also it's considered like the traditional way to eat it.
So these are thinner noodles than usual. This is exactly how I like my noodles. I don't want my noodles to be too soft.
This is how I like my noodles too though. Oh, this is fantastic.
I think this is the first time I thoroughly enjoy the shoyu base. It's like a really dark consomme. So you have the oiliness on your lips, but you feel the taste of it on the side of your tongue more.
You have this kind of like salty, but then kind of like a sweet flavor in the background.
I've had ramen with fish broth in it, and the fish can be very overwhelming at times. But this right here, the fish isn't in the foreground. It's like a background. All I want to say is deep. Everything
You're not
is mad
depth-y?
Deep.
Sun.
No.
Depth-y? Okay, so the basic ramen comes with senju onion, which is like a green onion that's from the Kanto region.
Yeah.
Bamboo shoots, menma. It comes with two different kinds of pork in it. So you've got the shoulder roast char siu and also the pork back ribs char siu.
I can't believe how soft this meat is. You don't even need teeth. You could just mush this against the roof of your mouth with your tongue like cotton candy.
And it also comes with narutō, which I know people out there are being like, you mean the anime guy? It's a little squiggle on his forehead. And then it also comes with a soft boiled egg. Oh yeah, ooh.
Now the key to your eggs is supposed to cut it in half vertically, not horizontally. So you have two equal halves. And then you gotta leave it in the broth a bit so the inside yolk can warm up. Because now it's nice and gooey, warm. If you just bite your egg right away, it's gonna be a little bit cold. But this is perfect now.
Oh man, fantastic.
Holy shit. No, I thought this was just gonna be an informative video in which you talk about chugusoba, but I really
you
like this.
Wrong.
This is me fangirling over really good ramen.
We are located in a business district, so during rush hour lunchtime, we get mostly businessmen. On weekends, we get like ramen mania, those who read ramen magazine, and they come here to enjoy, test our ramen.
I'm like a huge advocate of people trying out different types of ramen. You think that you've tried one and you like understand ramen, but you absolutely don't.
Yeah.
Every place has its own little special way to make things, its own way to make noodles. If you're in Tokyo, Tokyo has a Tokyo style of ramen, right? When we went to Fukuoka, has its own style. So don't just go to one place and say, you know, oh, well, I tried it and it's all the same. Absolutely not. You need to make like a bucket list and be like, I'm gonna come try chukusoba when I come to Tokyo. I'm gonna have this amazing ramen with its awesome broth with all of its like super, oh wow, you just went ahead and finished before me.
Told you, I came here hungry, girl. I had to take off my jacket because I'm getting a little bit sweaty from how happy I am. But the thing I like about this is that this is salaryman style ramen. This isn't fancy hoity-toity ramen with doilies and like weird trendy music happening. This is a nostalgia. Your grandma's home-cooked comfort food ramen. I wish my grandma made ramen like this.
Wish I had a grandma. Kind of just got sad. The thing that I also like about this ramen is that like chukusoba has that feeling of like homemade. Did you just steal my ramen? In the middle of an important conversation point
that I
was having?
I just had to make sure if we had the same style of ramen. I think because I had more meat in mind, it has a more meaty flavor.
I see.
That is my observation. Wait, I had more seaweed in mind. Let me test the seaweediness.
世界に誇れる日本の食べ物だと思っております。ぜひ皆さんご賞味してください。ありがとうございます。
Why I'm freaking stuffed.
I'm warm. Can I take off my shirt as well?
I don't
How about
think
my pants?
Too sexy.
Salary men should be allowed to take off their pants at a ramen restaurant. You need to feel the comfort of home.
So guys, I'm just going to say, if you're coming to Tokyo or if you live here already, you cannot say that you love ramen without having chukusoba, the OG of ramen, of the ramen world, if you will.
That'd be like saying you like ice cream and never having vanilla ice cream. You have to try vanilla ice cream.
I guess that makes sense.
Right?
Yeah.
So if you want directions on how to come to Katsumoto and have the chukusoba, we left them below in the link in our info box. So make sure you click on that.
We're going to have to just eat more here. I think we need to take like all the different options in the menu and just, we should just do for science. Let's pop outside and go to the vending machine and get more tickets.
You go. I'm going to finish up your broth because you haven't.
Okay. I'm going to go get some more tickets. Okay.
Yeah.
Two more. Yeah.
Damn. Holy shit. That's really f***ing good. Really f***ing good. Wow.
Oh, You thought this video would end without a sexy food porn voiceover? Well, you were mistaken. Get those headphones in, because I'm going to embarrass you by letting everyone know what you're watching. Ramen, that's right. You're watching ramen and you're not ashamed of it. Look at the way it lifts out of that broth. Ooh, I could just watch that all day and put that egg in my mouth.